The show you're tuned into right now was put together by students and staff enrolled in the broadcasting courses in the radio television department at San Joaquin Delta College. Thanks for listening and supporting college radio.
Hello. You and I are not the same. You are a fool. I am an angel named Satan. I come from Earth 2020. No. Not from the year 2020. The 2020th Earth in the known universe. Just like your reality. Earth 2020 is a small, crowded planet if you don't have the inheritance to make it yours. Earth 2020 is populated and overrun by you so-called human beings. Worthless and greedy in nature. It's as if the last thing you beings will ever be is humane. I'm sure that sounds familiar. The people here are so curious and divisive in their customs. At times, it seems like the only thing they agree on is that they don't agree at all. I'm sure that sounds familiar too. But I'm not here to talk about our similarities, fool. I'm here to talk to you about politics. Yes, we suffer from that too. Like you, we're not very good at picking who is to rule. Like you, our systems are flawed. Like you, we're so horrible at picking our leaders. Tinker, tailor, soldier, spy, rich man, businessman, war criminal, pedophile, Pinocchio, rapist, thief. Our leaders wear so many masks, it's hard to pick the right one. And the masks are so harmless in nature. Pig, fish, elephant, donkey, rat. There was one leader who hid behind a certain mask. A mask of a mouse. A mouse named Mickey.
Yeah, that's real.
This leader entertained us for years and years. He hid behind a harmless mask that made us smile at the park. We chose him because we were in love with him. His ideas were rooted in our childhoods. We only picked him because we thought it'd be entertaining. Like living in a sitcom. This is now a horror. I'm sure that sounds familiar too. But it's not about who doomed us. It's not about the leader. It's about who saved us. It's about our hero. This is a story about a creature. A creature bigger than you and me. A creature of the land. Not a creature of the sea. A creature who liberated Earth from our one true curse. Walt Disney.
Yeah, that's real, all right.
This is a story about a creature extinct in your time. A creature named Gigantopithecus.
The universal frog is croaking. The locusts are gathering at the gate. My lungs are unintentionally blacker than ever. By the dawn's early light, I cannot see. I can't see. I can't see. This eternal darkness gave proof through the day. Nothing was ever there. But I see a light. I see a star. Just like me, you know what to do when you see a star, don't you?
What's your favorite Disney movie?
Tom Arbunda.
I think I hear a song coming along.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Anything you're your heart desires will come true.
Here he comes! Alex Solon. Gigantopithecus!
Oh, he's mad, all right! The Ice Age is gonna take us out. I'll stand here waiting for you now.
I got concerned with your blood money. I just want you to give me a sequel.
You don't know that word, do you, fool?
You wouldn't know that word if you slapped you in the face.
You wouldn't know that word if you killed everyone you weren't concerned with. You wouldn't know that word if you made the earth hotter. And you wouldn't know that word if it choked me to death. Forced me to buy oxygen. That should be free. On Earth, you think that'd be a guaranteed.
But you think I'm a fool, don't you? You think I'm the greedy one, don't you?
Asking for a home where my entire family can live. Asking for air my entire family can breathe. Asking for security for my entire family when you have your guns pointed at us. Am I foolish or do I have dreams?
You never dreamt a day in your life, have you, fool? You never dreamt because you already had it all.
You never dreamt of becoming something bigger because you were already big. But you're not as big as me. Ain't that right, fool?
Gigantopithecus.
I'm done wishing, I'm done praying, and I'm done asking. Next time you cross me, your castle's gonna fall. Both of them. Next time you cross me, the last thing you're gonna hear is...
Oh, he's
battle,
right?
Tom Arbonda.
Point of view. You're just another Virgil. I'm just another Dante. Lost past my expiration. I arrived on a Thursday, screaming my head off at the violence above. Knowing my kids would have to fight for their favorite flavor of oxygen, sponsored by their favorite basketball player. The violence above all happened in the cave of the philosopher who stood before me. The walls came to life and put strings on our babies. Wooden boys and wooden girls all wished upon a star to be real, but were too tangled in their own strings to even stop and feel. Guiding me through the philosophical corridors of limbo, my hopes were abandoned, but a goal was kept close to my heart. My endeavor was pointless if poetic justice is real, but knowing my heart isn't above ground.
Have you wished upon a star?
The store smelled like the deflowering of a donkey, and nothing was gleaming. I was hoping he didn't get caught in that breeze. I was hoping his pleasures were minimal in his lifetime. You told me I wouldn't like what I saw here. That the sight would be oh so weird when I passed the past lover. Cleopatra, as a feather floats divinely, to think my heart once stopped with hers. Rushed with contradicting emotions. My heart remembers. Cleopatra. Cleopatra. My chest is pierced as Francesca's. An asp slithering down my esophagus. My memory of her hurts. This wasn't the place. I had to move on.
Like a creature from another time.
The second door opens. A depressing summer. A great storm of putrefaction. A ghost made of winter hugs my bloody face. Cold crystal blues shatter on my orange hair. In discomfort and in love, do I admit I miss Cleopatra. Go if you don't feed him mud. Don't trust a single one of his heads, my love. Each head pretends they love you. And you may think he loves you for your money, but I know what he really loves you for. It's the mud you feed him. Make you howl like a dog if you don't feed him that mud. Feed him that mud. Money was made up before I was born. I didn't agree to this. Those children died on that mud before I was born. I didn't agree to this. I reject human nature.
It's all because of you. I'm feeling sad.
Third door opens. Look how far you've come. Look how far we've come. How much have you done today? How much have I done today? You raised me to greatness. Then you plunge me to poverty. How much more will you ask for? How much more can you ask for? Old rules were made up before I was born. You can't expect me to not get angry. You can't expect me to not raise my fist. I didn't agree to this. Will you punish them, Pluto? Will you serve them, Pluto? You're a loyal dog. But who are you loyal to, Pluto? Bark, Pluto. Bark for me, Pluto.
Papa Satan. Papa Satan, I love it.
Papa Satan. Papa Satan, Aleppe. Why do you hoard? Why do you waste? Bring that rock near me, and you'll see a disgrace.
It's all because of you. I'm feeling sad.
All the doors are closed. And all the windows are wide open. Lord, let me know mine end. Lord, let me know his end. Rationalities stacked against my endeavor. Will I lie at the bottom of this river? Mutilate me with the tree and crush me with the rock. Will I fight at the top? Spare me the tragic ending I know I've reaped. Fight. Drown for me.
Open a door, let me in.
Her serpent eyes turned me to stone, and I shattered myself out of anger.
Open a door, let me in. May you long remain. May you long remain.
Playing devil's advocate, then you got permission to send me straight to hell. I mean, those kids were the most annoying back in the day, and if you're still playing that past 18, then your tongue is just slipping at this point. Like, where about the ketchup stains on your shirt, dude? Always on some riddle me this shit. How about you riddle me this? I don't know, shut the fuck up. I mean, your dumbass loves to explode when I stand my moral ground without any solution. These dumbass kids think you need a solution to have a moral stance. I'ma have a moral stance regardless, dude. And you can agree, disagree, or shut the fuck up. Literally, those are your only three options.
You play God, don't you, fool?
You reject nature, don't you, fool? You draw animals and pretend they talk, don't you, fool? But you don't actually talk to animals. That would be weird. You kill animals on your off time. Ain't that right, fool? And that's not weird at all. Because you're beautiful. And I'm ugly. You'll never believe me. But I was walking this planet long before you. Long before you started crawling out the water. Which we thought was weird. Long before you started leaving your caves. Which we thought was weird. Long before you saw the shiny golden ball in the sky and thought it was God. Which we thought was stupid. You reject me, don't you, fool? Because I'm ugly. And you're beautiful. You shoved me in a tomb on fire. And said I went against nature. Because my hands are bigger than yours. Because I'm bigger than you ever were.
I've been gnawing my own flesh every night, waiting for the chance to gnaw yours. Now Christ is dead. Are we mice or are we men? She sleeps and she sleeps, and now she's inanimate.
Oh, he's mad, all right.
I've been gnawing my blood every night, waiting for the chance to see you burn in it. Now Christ is dead. Are we mice or are we men? I looked to the ceiling and could have sworn I saw you hanging.
It's all because of you.
At the top of the mountain was thunder, and I could have sworn your head was missing. It's a small world after all, Walt. In all my dreams, you're dead. In reality, you're dead. Warp cancer took you, but it should have been me. The sand will burn through your skin as it rains down on you. Tearing you inside out, my arms will pick at you. If you were a tree, I'd climb you.
It's getting hot in here.
Because I'm bigger than you. I'm bigger than you ever were. Are we mice or are we men to you? What are those dwarfs you love? I'll see you in eight.
So the devil really looked at Giganto in the eye looking for a tussle.
All my efforts amounted to nothing. And I stood there in silence, waiting for a feeling more primal. But this is what defeat feels like. You mastered trichinology beyond the stars. You tricked God. And now you're in heaven. And I'm here. This comedy not so divine. This comedy not so divine. I waited for you. But now, Walt Disney in treachery. The devil hid in plain sight. and now I was exactly what you wanted me to be. Wrathful. The devil hid in plain sight. And now I was exactly what you wanted me to be. Primal. This is for my family. This is for my identity. This is for your mother. You let die in a gas leak.
Nobody really wins when you cross the Gigantopithecus, man. Maybe you'll learn that later in life, but I don't know.
The creature entered the Inferno as an angry beast, and left the Inferno as a hero. The creature entered the Inferno on a Thursday, and he left it on a Tuesday. This day, I remember for the rest of my life. And though others weren't there, they seemed to remember it too. Earth 2020 remembers this day as Forgiveness Day. The root of all our evil was murdered, and in turn liberated us. That day, the protests stopped. That day, every flag burned. That day, Wall Street fell. Yes, harmony does exist somewhere in the universe. But that day in your world wasn't like that, was it? That day in your world was the opposite. Your castles fell that day. Both of them. And that doomed any chance of harmony left in your world. That day forever changed relations among your people. Put the idea in people's head how others should be, based on their image alone. That day left your own people suffocating in the void. Screaming for identity in a space that would rather silence them. Maybe I'm just a fool like you. My country tells me it's great and doesn't mention the corpses above and below it. I used to want to be American in my youth.
Gigantopithecus!
The Declaration of Independence says all men are created equal and we're all endowed with certain unalienable rights. I used to want to be a police officer in my youth. Science tells us the earth is getting hotter and the earth is past the point of redemption. I used to want to be a scientist in my youth. My father told me grown men don't cry and they always stay strong. I used to want to be a father in my youth. My phone tells me Steve Jobs is a great hardworking man and hides the children he made billions off of. I used to want to be Steve Jobs in my youth. My television tells me Walt Disney was a good person, and this meant he wasn't racist, sexist, and treated his workers with respect. I used to want to be Walt Disney in my youth. You tell me money runs the world, and you step on my back as you told me so.
I never wanted to be you anyways.
Time and time again, on my suspicious valley, this never-ending cycle desire. Will I get what I want? Time and time again, do I settle for mediocrity and for what? Silence? Or more mediocrity. The silence is loud and it's beginning to hurt my ears. The silence is mediocrity, now it's harmful to those around me. My silent memory shows me an orchard losing its values. Leaves dying, wood rotting, apples falling. It's nearly a long way down, but the apple doesn't fall too far from the tree. You've heard that one before. A long way down for an apple is nothing when its very natural foundation catches it, comforts it, does what it can to keep the apple. Why do we try so hard to keep this orchard alive? This orchard no longer serves us. This is not the Godland, and these apples fall so far from the Godland. Had its orchard been riddled with the forbidden fruit, would they too fall? And would they too fall far? What is forbidden in an orchard riddled with chaos? Earn it. Earn it all.
What's your least favorite Disney movie?
I would have to say my least favorite Disney movie is Frozen. To me, the movie really had no flow. It moved really fast. Then they added the trolls. It came out of nowhere. Like, they had nothing to do with the movie at all. The only thing I can really a credit is the villain. But overall, Frozen is pretty bad in my opinion. There's a lot of singing too. Like, there's really no normal conversation. Like, probably one sentence and then like 4 minutes of music. And overall, Disney f***ed up on Frozen.
What's your least favorite Disney movie?
I mean, I'm probably gonna say Ralph Breaks the Internet, just because this is like the point where Disney chooses money over quality products or so, because the film is just one flex of the many properties of Disney, which they had some like smart decisions, like making like stormtroopers like police and everything like that. It's just like you can see the cash grab with this movie or so. And by the point I mean where Disney chooses money over quality, you just see that at this point with this one and later on with Frozen 2. And there's like a whole entire documentary on Disney Plus right now where you see like these people pretty much panicking, and they know that they're gonna make money off of this movie either way. Like, there was like not any treatment. But yeah, they always had this like feeling with like the recent Disney releases on how it was more money over quality, and the fact that everything, they throw everything out that I love about the first Wreck-It Ralph for some sorry excuse on this one. I just can't explain it. I just feel like everything was just thrown out from the first one.